Yeah, hi and welcome back everyone to the supplementary coding along video series for the Build a Large Language Model from Scratch book. Here we are now going to talk about chapter 2, working with text data, which means essentially that we are going to prepare the data that we are going to use to train the LLM. Yeah, just to go to the chapter itself, chapter 2, you can see there are lots of sections starting at the top. The goal really here is to prepare the data set for the LLM. So there is actually a nice figure here that shows you this step in the grand scheme of the whole LLM building process. So here, building an LLM means setting up the data set, coding the attention mechanism, coding the LLM architecture, and so forth. This is really the first stage of, you know, training the LLM. And then the pre-training comes in stage 2. And then later on in stage 3, we will be fine-tuning the LLM. But, you know, just to keep things focused, here we are going to talk about preparing the data set. And yeah, to give you another view here, essentially what we are going to do is we are going to take text and tokenize it, and then convert these tokenized subparts of the text into token IDs, which we will be then encoding into vectors. I know this is maybe a bit fast here in this video, so I mentioned before the videos are not as detailed as the book itself, and they're more focused as supplementary resource for the coding examples. But yeah, just to give you the big picture here, so the goal is really to prepare raw text data so that the LLM can then process it. It's really that the LLM works with text, but you know, we have to first convert it into a format that it can be that can be read, let's say, in a form that the LLM understands, which in that sense here is actually vectors, like mathematical vectors. And if I scroll up a bit, it's really like the idea also that vectors are numeric representations here of this text. So that is our goal, going from letters and words into a more numeric representation, which can then be used later on during the pre-training to optimize the weight parameters of that LLM. But yeah, I don't want to go too far ahead and talk about pre-training. The focus here really is on preparing here the input data for the LLM. And specifically in section 2, tokenizing text, the focus is really also only on this subpart here at the bottom, where we take some input text and we break it down into individual smaller chunks. And and this is a process known as tokenization. Just to show you an example, so we will be using a library called TickToken later. And there is, I think, a nice virtual visualization, tick tokenizer, when we go here. And they do have different LLMs. For example, there is this GPT-2 LLM. If we type some text, let's say, hello world, something like this, this is a test. So here you can really see how it's broken down into individual tokens. So you can see hello is a token, the comma is a token, world is a token, dot is a token, and these are the token IDs. We will get to the token IDs later on, how they are created. For now, the focus is really like to just break it down into individual parts. And we are not going to implement actually the exact same algorithm that is used here. I do have some bonus material on doing that I will share later. Here, first, we want to do the big picture level of how we can actually break down text into individual chunks. So one way would be essentially to use just regular expressions. But starting sequentially, like how I did in the book, let's actually download the data set first, and we will be using the data set later in this chapter to actually implement the data loaders in PyTorch. So let's start with a data set here before I go too much ahead and talk about all the other things. So we are going to use a library, OS, which is just a standard Python library, and URL lib request, which is also a standard Python library. This is usually for working with files, and this is for downloading things from the internet. So the data set we are going to work with here, it's called the verdict. So let me just go here and make a new tab. And the verdict is a short story by Edith Wharton. So it's available as public domain data. I think there's a Wikipedia version that is actually quite nice here. So this is a very short story here, and I picked this one as the data set because, yeah, we want to keep things simple, that it doesn't take too long when we are actually pre-training the LLM, because it's more for educational purposes. And it's also, you know, pretty simple, readable, and most importantly, it's a public domain data set or book. So that means we can use it without having to worry about copyright restrictions, for example, in the United States at least. So in that case, this is an open public domain data set. There is no concern using this, for example, for LLM training. Okay, so we would download this data set. So we could, what we could do is we could go here, just copy and paste this and create a new file, a text file, insert this and save it and so forth. I have a little bit of a quicker way here. So I actually, let me just copy and paste this. I have it also in the GitHub repository for the book. And so this link is a URL link to the place on GitHub where I provided this data set, just in case, you know, in the future, the data set might become unavailable from Wikipedia or something. Here you can find a version in the book's GitHub repository, RASBT, LLMs-from-scratch. And in chapter two, in the first folder, main chapter code, I included the verdict here. And if you want to copy something from GitHub as raw text, you have to click on this raw here, and then you get the raw text, which in this case, as you can see, is similar to what you can see on this page. So if I copy this URL now, insert it here, it's really the same URL that you have seen earlier without all the line breaks. When I execute this code, it will download this data set and save it to a file, the-verdict.txt. Let me do that. And then maybe refresh here. And you can see it's now in this folder. So it's locally now on our computer. The next step would be opening this file in Python. So right now it's just sitting in our computer. And the next step would be opening this. So let me just copy this. And we are just reading it, so the R here. And then on Windows, it's, I think, required to specifically say which encoding we are using. So UTF-8, the standard encoding. And then we can just read the raw text here. And then let's double check. So we can double check that the text looks okay. So we can see, the Python interpreter has successfully loaded the text here. And we can also just double check, you know, how long it is. So I maybe recommend running this if you are running the code to check that you get approximately the same number here, which means you're not missing any character. So it should be about 20,479 characters if you loaded the dataset correctly. So let's now briefly introduce the concept of tokenization with regular expressions, which is just like a warm-up before we use the real, let's say, tick token library for tokenization. So we are going to use a Python regular expression, and let's actually use some simpler text. Let's, for the warm-up here, let's use the text I just typed in here and provide it here. Then we can type result and then the regular expression. And I must say that regular expressions are my weak spot, so I'm really not that good at them. But honestly, nowadays with LLMs like ChatGPT, it's actually pretty easy to figure it out. So this is essentially just a regular expression that splits on white space characters. And by the way, you don't have to really know what regular expressions are for the bigger context of training LLMs, because we are later using a tokenizer based on byte pair encoding. And I also have a from scratch implementation. It's not in the book, but it's in the supplementary materials that I can also maybe show you later. But yeah, for simplicity, our goal here, if you remember what I mentioned earlier, our goal here is first to split up this text into individual tokens. So let's do that with this regular expression and then maybe print the result and see how it looks like. And so yeah, we can see we have now the individual words and we have white space characters and so forth. One thing we might want to do is also to have the punctuation as separate characters. So for that, we would have to make a little bit of a more sophisticated regular expression. And like I told you, I'm not very good at regular expressions. So let me just copy and paste it here. So this is now a regular expression that is slightly more sophisticated. So this one will also include the punctuation as separate tokens, where before they were part of the word itself. Okay, so this is our simplest way of, you know, tokenizing. Now, as you have seen here, if I go here, there are actually no white space characters in the output here. So one thing we to mimic this could be, for example, that we are also going to strip the white space characters. This is just like an optional thing we could do. We can just get rid of the white space characters. So here I just have a simple list comprehension that will strip out the white space characters. So you can see now that is the result without white space characters. It's a bit different from what you see here, because this is a sophisticated byte pair encoding algorithm, and I will talk more about this later. I will share some, we have a dedicated section on this actually. But so here, for now, we're just building a very simple version of that to understand roughly what we are doing here, like how we are tokenizing text. Doing it a bit more advanced now, I mean, this is a nice way to handle simple cases, but now imagine we have a more complicated case like that. So this will actually fail, really. It doesn't really take care of special characters like, you know, the double dash and everything. So we can actually make it more sophisticated. So I have now like a more sophisticated regular expression, and also again the white space stripping, and that does a good job of, you know, separating words and special tokens. So we did a lot of work here now to prepare our text by splitting it into individual tokens and punctuation characters. So we tested it on this simple example, but let's actually use this on our real text. So for that, what we have to do now is we have to actually use our raw text. Well, raw text is what we have here at the top. So that's our raw text. Let's actually see what happens when we do that. So yeah, so we tokenized our raw text, and now let's see how many tokens we have. So we have a length of, let me actually save this as a variable, because this is a lot of code. Let's just call it preprocessed. And then, so yeah, we have here 4,690 tokens. So what we have done so far in section 2.2 is we took raw text and we tokenized it. And now in the next section, we will be talking about converting this raw text into these so-called token IDs.
Get this book at manning.com